Hello everyone, today I am going to make this panel door with parameters so that you can also alter its dimensions whenever you want. In the previous video, I have shown you guys how to make a frame of door. The link is given in the description box. Go to floor plan, select reference plane and place two reference planes, one at this point and the other one at this point. Place a reference line at this point. Select the measure command and place dimensions between these two reference planes and these two reference planes. Assign parameter to this dimension and name it door width. Assign a parameter to this dimension as well and name it thickness of frame. Or frame thickness, whatever you want. Select align command, select this reference plane, paste mouse pointer here, press tab button on keyboard. So you see this blue button, click on it, lock this reference plane, repeat this process on the horizontal reference plane as well. Now this reference line will move between these two reference planes at this point. Select the angular dimension and place the dimension between this reference plane and reference line. Assign a parameter to this angular dimension and name it door angle. Assign the parameter of door width to this reference line as well. Open properties dialog box. Assign a formula in the door width parameter, which is wall opening minus frame thickness multiplied by 2. Close the parentheses. Now if you will change the dimension of wall opening, the dimension of door width will change as well because of that formula. Go to heated elevation and place a dimension from this point to this point. And from this point to the bottom. Assign parameter to this dimension and name it door height. Give this dimension the parameter of frame thickness. Go to properties dialog box and enter a formula which is height minus frame thickness. So whenever you change the height of door, the door height also changes as well. Go back to floor plan, select extrusion, set the reference plane to this reference line and draw a rectangle of door at an offset of 2 inches. Close it down and set the extrusion end to door height. The simple 3D of door with no panels is now complete. And it looks like this. Now go to floor plan and close this door by adding an angle of 0 degree. Go to interior elevation, select the reference plane and start placing reference planes as shown in the video. After placing these reference planes, open a new family file of profile. In this file, I am going to make a negative sectional elevation of panel. For that, I am going to import this image and place it here. Adjust the dimensions as shown. Once you have adjusted the image, start drawing the sectional elevation with the help of this line drawing. Delete the image. And load this profile into the project. Select void sweep. Click on pencil sketch and select the reference plane to this extrusion. And draw a rectangle as shown in the video. Fillet these edges, click OK, go to 3D, load the profile, flip it, click OK. The first panel is now complete. Double click on this panel, enter into sketch path and place a angular dimension and place a dimension at these two points. Lock this dimension. Assign parameter to this dimension and provide a name to it. Go to properties dialog box and enter a formula as shown. Now repeat this process on all the other panels as shown in the video and add parameters where necessary. Now, when you change the dimension of door, the panels automatically changes their dimensions. But when I change the height of the door, the panels does not change its dimensions. It is because I haven't added parameters for the height. So now I am going to add parameters for the height as well. Now I am going to add panels on the back side of the door as well, because unfortunately you can't copy and paste this void sweep. The door is now complete. You can change the dimensions whenever you want. Place an arc as shown in the video to depict the opening of the door in the plan mode. Lock it down so that this arc also moves when you change the angle of door. Assign material to the door and the frame. Load this door into the file. You can change the dimension of the door in the project as well. I hope you like this tutorial. If you have any queries, feel free to ask. Also, if you want me to upload any specific tutorial, just tell me and I will try to upload it as soon as possible. I will meet you guys in the next video. Till then, goodbye and take care. And most importantly, don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more tutorials.